Probably cause your girl feeling me. It's a flag on the play, all these catching penalties. Look, I don't like your energy. I don't like the fake handshake, snake tendency. Let's go.
When I'm in my zone, I get it going, Donkey Kong. They got the hand out, will you give a dog a bone? I'm like, oh, nah, you gotta get it on your own. They get an attitude, I'm like, you better check your tone. They ain't got no job, need someone to take her home. I hop up in the car, whip like Indiana Jones. Going George Lucas, now I'm out here killing clones. Coming in strong, like, tear down, tear down, tear down, tear down, tear down. Boosted up my cardio, I used to get the run around. I've been doing this since I had to work at Mama House. Tear down.
Night beginning to fall over Southern California, but the lights are shining bright here at the spectacular SoFi Stadium in metropolitan Los Angeles. Tonight, we've got a great Sunday night matchup between the Los Angeles Rams and their Southern California rivals, the Los Angeles Chargers. Here's the kicker, Harrison Butker, ready to get this one started. And off we go to wrap up a great Sunday of football. Fielded right around the 8. And beyond the 20, but not by much. In fact, just a yard pass there to the 21. They'll run with Taylor to begin the drive. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. 11 yards there on the first play from scrimmage. Another good run there. He's been good all season long. I don't know if he's going to win that MVP award, but just to be in the discussion, obviously that means he's had a great run.
The raw numbers put him in the discussion. Can he carry his team to enough victories? Can he put them in a spot where we say to ourselves, well, an MVP carries his team to the playoffs? That's what he's going to need in order to get that award.
Fields throw caught by Tony. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. That one good for 13 and a Charger first. His first pass attempt of the game, Charles, and the pass rush was right there to hit him. But no fear, he delivered an accurate ball. Nice catch.
And you never want to see your quarterback getting hit, but it also sends a message to the rest of the team when he's able to take that shot and still deliver downfield. Showing a little toughness, and the team rallies around him. This could really help him on their drive.
And he's going to take this one across midfield and into Ram territory. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to 2nd and 4. The Chargers at 13-2 on the year. And they coming on a pretty good roll here. Winners of 3 straight.
And I thought that they played pretty well last week. Their execution, their discipline, their resilience, all on display in that victory.
Last run got 6, now 2nd and 4. They just do get the playoff as he'll look to throw. And on the left sideline, he caught it, but out of bounds, according to the head linesman. Incomplete, so the ball a little late getting there, and it's 3rd down. Well, this defense for the Rams, they were terrific last week in the win over Denver.
I have to admit, I was extremely impressed by what I saw on tape because they stayed in the face of the quarterback the entire game, ended up getting 4 sacks total, and made it difficult for him to step up and find receivers downfield. Also made it hard for him to escape the pocket and run.
So it was already a gain on the completion, but tack on some more with that penalty.
Absolutely, no matter what angle you're making the tackle from, you can't grab the face mask, and that's just putting your defense on its heels just a little bit more.
So a big penalty there on the face mask leads to 1st and 10. Running straight ahead, Taylor. 5 yards on the carry, good pickup on 1st down. He was solid last week, over 100 yards in their victory on the ground. They want to get that going again.
Absolutely. What they also understand is that from week to week, it's not necessarily the same, but they want it to be, right? What they saw last week on the ground, they want to see in this game as well.
After the pickup of 5, here's 2nd and 5. Now it's Fields. And this is going to be intercepted. It's the former Patriot, Devin McCourty. And the Rams are going to get possession here as they force the opening drive turnover. Well, it's no secret he's had trouble this year with interceptions, and this is a bad start for him. First drive, throwing another pick.
No matter who's broadcasting his game, that's how the conversation begins. Throwing too many interceptions, can he take care of the football? If I were his backup, I'd be edging towards the coaches and saying, hey, how about giving me an opportunity?
They'll start out on the ground. It's Leonard Fournette. He'll rumble for about six up across the 20 to the 22. So, CD, this defense, they know that they have to be at their very best when they're taking on a team here that's in the midst of a winning streak that's now stretched over multiple months, not weeks, months.
I think the challenge they put upon themselves is we want to be the guys to end that streak. And what's working in their favor? The winning streak on the other side. Sometimes that carries a burden with it because they feel like they have to play perfectly as well. Let's just go out there and get them is the idea.
They give him about four on the play, but he's marked short, so it'll be third and about the length of the football. Pretty good job defensively. Thought he was going to get it, but they knew where that marker was, and they stopped him just short of it.
What it does is emphasize that strategic football and situational football is not just played on the offensive side, is it? Defense understanding, as you noted, where the first down marker was and making sure they didn't get there.
They are such a talented team at defending the perimeter and taking away throws to the outside. Great confidence, great skill.
Zappe will try to sneak. Yeah, they will touch him down, but not before he gets the first. They only needed a few inches, but still some anxious moments there, but they do convert on fourth. Fournette, a first down carry. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. Byron Jones in there to make the tackle. You don't see that a ton, do you? A cornerback coming over to the middle of the field to make a run tackle.
That's someone with a ton of confidence to feel like nothing is pressuring him on his side of the field. Sees that the ball's moved to the middle and just sprints over there to help out. He ends up getting the tackle. Well played.
Second down, Zappe steps away to his left. He'll air this one deep for Anderson. All right, rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. Picked off by Andre Sisco. And the Chargers are going to take possession of the football.
Well, it's not the first time we've seen him give one up here during his rookie season. And in this case, zone coverage forced the mistake. He's made some strides week to week in how he's handling the different type of coverages that he's seeing. But clearly, there's some growing still to do.
Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. And this is caught. He's got it. Touchdown, LA. Mecole Hardman, his 14th touchdown now on the year. And the Chargers use the early turnover to get on the board first here in this one. Two able to connect on the extra point, and that makes the score 7-0. Following the touchdown, here's Koo to kick off. Cordarrelle Patterson to return it, bringing it out of the end zone. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get this up to the 29. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. They threw an interception the first time they had the football, wound up leading to a touchdown the other way. How do you approach drive number two?
Going back to your game plan coming in, everyone has matchups that they like better than others, where they think they have an advantage. Dial up some of those plays. Try and go to those spots and get your offense moving.
Throwing again on second down. Zappe, this one left side, caught by Patterson. second carry of the game for Cordero Patterson. And slow going there as he'll only get a yard, maybe, up to the 41.
Well, partner, I don't think it's any secret that any running back wants to be able to see a hole open so that he can gallop through it. But in this case, he had to slow down. There was really no hole there. And he took a big hit in order to get that 1 yard.
Here's second and 9, just a yard on that last run. Zappe. High throw, but the catch is made. And he's brought to the ground with another first down at the Chargers 40. 19 yards the pick up there. Move the chains. Zappe to throw on first down. He lets it fly for Lockett. And this one is incomplete.
Well, they've got man coverage on the outside, and my scouting report on these DBs tells me that they love to take matters in their own hands. They want man coverage, not zone. And there was good coverage there that forced the incompletion.
On second down, a run with Patterson. And a good push up front, and he's able to navigate his way down inside the 30. On first down, going back to Patterson. A good run there on first down, and it'll leave him with a second and 2.
A nice run here early on. It doesn't take a great play caller to realize you want to establish a guy of his caliber with runs like this early because they'll pay dividends as the game progresses.
On second down, here's Fournette. And he'll take it down here just shy of the 15 at the 16-yard line. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down. They'll run it again with Fournette. And they get to him quickly here as he stopped right around the 13. 3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and 7. Inside handoff now to Fournette. And he's going to be brought down just shy of the 5 at the 6. After 1, 7-0 on EA Sports. They'll try and run for it with Fournette. And he goes backwards on this one, losing yardage to the 7. Now from the 7, here's second and goal. Now Zappe will go to the air. And it's complete. He's got it in the end zone. Touchdown, Rams. Robbie Anderson, a 7-yard touchdown grab. And the Rams are an extra point away from drawing level. Extra point by Butker is on target, and we are tied at 7. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. This one taken just inside the 10. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. The Charger drive about to get going.
Well, partner, you know, coaches always say that every play is designed to score a touchdown. Sometimes that's not really true, but last drive, that was the case. One play to get into the end zone, and now they'll try to duplicate that success here.
And it's rare for those moments to happen. Incredible when they do. And you saw the celebration. Pure, unbridled joy after that one.
Ball on the 30. They'll come up with a second and 5. Now Fields. That's complete to Tony. And he'll be taken down, but not before they reach the 50. So the penalty declined, and they will keep the yardage on the completion.
And you could almost see him compartmentalize there throughout the route. Fought hard at the line of scrimmage, a lot of hand checking throughout the route. Great job staying focused on the football and pulling it in through the contact.
To the right side, this is Taylor. Credited with a 1-yard gain there to make it second and 9.
No doubt about it. Really nice job there by the defense, not allowing him to get to the perimeter. But that means your defensive ends, your outside linebackers, the guys that you pay big money to sack the quarterback, they also have to have interest in the running game as well. And they did a nice job there of holding the point of attack and not giving ground.
And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on, third down.
He did an okay job of absorbing the hit, just couldn't secure the football through the catch.
And he was right there on the spot and forced the incompletion. That's something defenders work on all the time. If you're there, make the contact, but continue to work your way through the receiver so that he can't possess the football and turn it into a catch.
And he's going to be taken down right at the 40-yard line.
And the tight end is certainly a position built to move the chains because they can control space underneath. If they've got good hands, then, of course, they're a dynamic target. But one other thing is they're right in the sight lines of a quarterback on just about every play, and that makes it easier for the quarterback to pick him out and deliver.
First down, here's White. And give him 6 yards here as he stopped near the 35 at the 34.
They've created a nice sustained drive off of plays like that. A nice strong run there that keeps him advancing the ball.
Six yards on that last play. Here's second and four. Fields eluding the pressure right. And he's going to be taken down back around the 35-yard line. And on third and five, this will be the eighth play of the drive. Back to throw, Fields. And this will be swung out wide for Taylor. And a pretty nice tackle there, ranging up from his free safety spot as he'll stop him about a yard short. It'll go as a gain of four. And that's going to make it fourth down.
A short gain that doesn't get him the first down brings up a fourth down situation.
Really nice job defensively. They knew where the sticks were. They got the stop before it. Needing the tough yards, they run it with their fullback. And he is going to have the Chargers first down as they manage to convert. And that'll keep the drive alive. Just a gain of three, but they'll certainly take it as they convert on fourth down. So this drive going to continue following the conversion on fourth. Here's first and ten. Here's Fields. Escaping the pressure right. This will be incomplete. Oh, a dream chance for a D lineman, but he couldn't pull that one in.
So it looks like they still have some fight in them on this series because it seemed like things were headed for the red zone. But if this defense gets two more stops, they can keep them out of that area.
Throwing again on second and ten. Fields. And this will be caught in the end zone for a Chargers touchdown. Mecole Hardman with touchdown number 15 on the year and second of the game. And the Chargers have taken the lead. Extra point by Koo up and good. And that makes the score 14-7. Koo just hit the field goal. Now he kicks off. From his end zone, here comes Patterson. And he's able to get this across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked out officially at the 21. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. As this offense comes back out here, Charles, they're trailing in this ball game, and they've been on the sideline for a while. They did score their last time out, but they just had to watch that long, sustained drive, so we'll see if they can shake the rust off.
Yeah, and that's always a question that you have when you have to come off the bench after having sat there for a long time. Are you ready to go? Are you loosened up? But even more so, are you mentally alert and ready to put your best product out there?
An extra cornerback now in the game for the Chargers here on third. Now Zappe. He hits his target, Lockett. And he's taken down right at the 45-yard line. A big one there on third down. They hit for 30 yards. So the big play moves them all the way across midfield. It's first and 10 from the 45.
Zappe now on first and 10.
Rolling to his left. And this is caught by Watkins. And he'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. 25 yards that time. Solid catch there for a man who's been so brilliant this year. Worth pointing out, as we were talking about earlier, there has never in the 60-year history of the award been a pass catcher, tight end or wide receiver, that has taken home the MVP trophy.
And the best receivers I've talked with, they know that stat, and it drives them crazy because they understand.
And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Rams.
Leonard Fournette, his third rushing touchdown of the year. And the Rams are an extra point away now from tying this ball game. Extra point by Butker is on target.
And we are tied at 14. This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. And no effort to bring this one out. It's a touchback. The Charger drive about to get going. And that last drive, so effective in the passing game, resulting in the touchdown. Maybe not many people were focused on the trenches. There was good protection there.
Excellent protection. So now, defensively, you've almost got to get down to those starters blocks like you're a sprinter. Get lower than those guys on offense and find a way to roar through them or around them to get into the face of the passer.
Easier said than done, though.
Way easier said than done. But they've got to try something because right now they're just cutting them to shreds.
17 yards for the Chargers there as they've got themselves a first down. A shotgun snap, Fields. That's caught left side by Hardman. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. On second down, it's Taylor. And he'll be brought down at the 48-yard line. 2 yards on the pickup, and that's all they needed to move the sticks.
Second and one is often an invitation to take the big shot downfield. I'll bet the offensive lineman said, are you kidding? We just get on our backs and let's go get the first down. They love being physical.
Now a first down throw, Fields.
To the right side, complete to Taylor. Now he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30. The Chargers passing game rolling a bit here. They've got another first.
Well, he was a busy man out of the backfield a week ago. They got the ball early and often. I have no doubt in my mind that he'll be a big part of the game plan here as well.
From the 32 now, here's first and 10. They'll go up the middle with White. On the stop was Aaron Donald.
That's a really nice, tough run inside, and they gained 5 yards on it. And to be frank about it, most offenses don't expect to get 5 yards on a play call like that. So when they do, they go back to their huddle with a little pep in their steps. They're starting to think that they're starting to dominate the line of scrimmage.
And he'll be a couple yards shy of the red zone here at the 22-yard line. That's now consecutive 5-yard carries to pick up the first down.
I know flashy plays as people like to call them, that attracts a lot of attention. But let's face it, when you're efficient, that can control a ball game. And I love the game plan they've got going right now.
Back-to-back 5-yard gains, didn't force the ball downfield, picked it up on the ground.
Yeah, offensive line, they're getting it done.
2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down. They run once more with Taylor. And he's only going to get a yard from the 20 to the 19.
Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
And he's going to be taken down short of the first, right around the 15-yard line. And we're going to get a timeout. With 2 seconds remaining in the second quarter. Now a timeout coming here defensively. As on fourth down, may as well make him punt it. So with 2 ticks left here in the half, on is the field goal unit. This just 32 yards officially from the right hash.
Koo knocks this one through the post.
So we've come upon halftime here in week 17 as we send you to Orlando to check in with Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach? The final two quarters of the NFL regular season are upon us as the second half of Week 17 is underway. Patterson going to bring this out of the end zone. And his guys will get the football right at the 20-yard line. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line.
Well, Charles, in that first half, we saw a fair amount of offense on both sides of the football, and now the team trailing here will start with it in the third quarter.
And we both know this coach pretty darn well, don't we? Because his game planning is always on point. And now that he's getting the ball to start the second half, how about all the offense that you already referenced in the first half? He'll put that all together and come out with something really strong, I believe, to get things going here in the third quarter.
Zappi's throw here complete into the hands of Ertz. And he'll get this up to the 34-yard line. 60 catches for him now on the year. This last one, a first down.
And that's a nice throw right there. And I'll tell you what I've seen in recent times and actually watched a presentation in the offseason from a college offensive coordinator that showed about 10 different drills that he runs with his quarterbacks to show them how to get out of the pocket, how to get comfortable when they're doing so, and to make plays under that type of duress. That's an example of what we're seeing the colleges deliver to the NFL. Oh, that's a real nice job there by the defensive front. They just engaged and held their ground. But how about the guy who made the play? We often talk about whether they take a good first step or not. Many times you just don't take any step. Just get your feet moving, get your body going. And then once he made the read, he was able to make the play.
Throwing on second and eight. Zappi looking left side and he's got a man. That's Patterson. And he's dropped right at the 40. Gain of three. Here's Zappi. He finds his man complete. That's Watkins. Touchdown, LA! Quez Watkins, 60 yards. And the Rams have taken the lead here this third quarter. Extra point by Butker is on target. And that will make this a four-point game. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. This one taken just inside the 10. And he won't quite make it to the 25. The Charger drive about to get going. And they'll be working from behind now following the touchdown a moment ago on the opening drive of the half.
I think the guys right now, as they go out on offense.
Oh, that's into a sea of bodies, and it's intercepted. Shaquille Griffin with a pick. And the Rams are going to take possession of the football. So from the 36 now, first and 10. Up the gut, Fournette, nothing doing. Barely able to muster a yard to hit the 35.
Yeah, things were pretty stacked up there in the middle of the line. A lot of bodies, not much space. I think ultimately, he was fortunate to get anything out of that run.
On second and nine, Zappi forced out to his left. He'll check this one off to Fournette. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. 16 yards is the pickup there and a first down for L.A. First and 10, it's Patterson. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. No gain on the play there, a second down.
As usual, the hallmark of a good run defense, linebackers making plays near the line of scrimmage. Absolutely nowhere to run there.
So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10. Zappi back to throw. Being chased out left. And that falls to the ground incomplete. A nice nice job of bodying him up defensively. And now it brings up third down.
Well, no surprise there. He was looking for one of his favorite targets again as soon as he left the pocket. But the coverage was good downfield. They got right to the receiver and helped prevent that completion.
Zappe on third down. And he's left with no option here but to throw it away.
Oh, that's going to hurt a bit because they needed to come through with a completion there. Now a drive that started with great field position is facing fourth down.
Butker's kick here is good, and they will open their lead up to a touchdown at 24-17.
Well, they're able to come away with the interception, Charles. They aren't able to move the ball all that much. However, they do get three out of it with a field goal.
Yeah, and anytime you do force a turnover, you have to come out of it with points. Everybody wants six. They'll take the three there. Now it's their opportunity to do it again.
The Charger drive about to get going.
This offense returning out there, and really, you remember the last drive, Charles, it was over before it even began. They threw the interception on the very first play.
And what that means is for all these guys, it's been a while since they've been out there going full speed, so they've got to get everyone back out there, run a couple of your go-to plays, make sure you get your offense oiled up a little bit. They've got to be able to start fast, but they've got to be efficient as well.
Especially the quarterback.
A big play there for L.A. So now then, the big play has him all the way inside the 30 now, first and 10. They'll run the toss here with Taylor. And he stopped immediately there. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. They're losing here in the third quarter, maybe trying to get the ball outside, bust a big play. Obviously didn't work there.
And while it didn't work, I really can't fault them for trying it. You and I have talked to the offensive coordinator, and we knew that that was a place they wanted to try and go. And sometimes you just have to stick with it because 2 yard gains turn into 20 yard gains as the game goes along.
This defense is continuing to contest every deep ball that is thrown downfield. And look, it doesn't matter whether you're playing man or zone. Eventually, that becomes man on man. And you've got to trust yourself and go up at that moment of truth and make a play on the football.
And he'll get this to the 23, but that'll be well short of what he needed. 5 yards that time out of the scramble. But now they're looking at a fourth down situation.
Like any team playing, they're looking for touchdowns to try and help their cause. But in this case, he does get them a little closer at least if they think a field goal turns out to be the better call here.
Koo knocks this one through the post. So he's been automatic to this point of the season, and he connects on the field goal there.
And what a luxury it is to have a kicker you can depend upon, partner, because he hasn't missed all year long. Converts on that one as well. And kudos to you. You didn't jinx him.
From his end zone, here comes Patterson. And they'll get him down right around the 25, actually the 26 officially. So a net gain of one there. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And they split the uprights last time for three. They've got the lead. They're not going to play this conservative. They're not hoping for another field goal. They're hoping for a touchdown.
I'm with you on that one. I like where your head is. I like the way you're thinking because you're exactly right. Trying to sit on a lead and play that way, that doesn't work too well for most teams. Run your offense. Yeah, run what
put
you
your
do
foot
best.
On the gas.
Exactly. Put it all the way down and try to increase your lead in a big way. And the best way to do it, touchdowns.
73 yards for him on the ground now. He has been a tough man to bring down all night.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
So a good run by Fournette. Now another first and 10. They'll try and run this one right up the gun. And he'll be taken down just shy of midfield. Jeremy Chinn there defensively.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
The first down run got five. Here's second and five. Zappe looks to throw it. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down.
Well, so much for getting separation. No chance there. Locked down tight, forcing the incompletion on that attempt.
They come up now, third and five, following the incomplete pass. And Zappe to throw. Open man there is Patterson, complete. And he's got this to the 30 before being taken down. Great way to convert on third down there. 21 yards the play.
A lot of times the key is just get him the ball and let him do his thing. And they got it out to him on the left side. And he did exactly that. Excellent run after the catch.
They go back to the ground now with Fournette. A short gain here, maybe a yard to the 29. Now it's second and nine. Now Zappe. Oh, that's into double coverage and intercepted. Jeremy Chinn picks it off. And the Chargers are going to have it here as they'll start at their own 24-yard line.
A feather in the cap for the defender, picking off one of the league's better quarterbacks so far this season. And add another feather in the cap for the coaches, too. Excellent game plan, and they had their guys aware of his ability to roll out and how to defend against it.
The Charger drive about to get going. They'll run with Taylor to begin the drive. And nothing much materializing there on the first down run. He'll get a couple, and that's it.
They know that old expression, it's not my night. It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
Every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play. Second down, another run with Taylor. And he'll go down, and that will do it for the third quarter of action. One quarter remains here on a Sunday night. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. So from the 36 now, first and 10. Here's Fields. Throw taken in by Taylor, left side. They'll wind up getting seven on the play, and it'll be second down. Looked like a pretty good, safe play right there. No, he's had trouble with the interceptions in this game there. Hits his guy out in the flat.
Yeah, so many times we hear quarterbacks and offensive coordinators talk about, in your progressions, you're either throwing the touchdown or you're throwing the check down. But earlier in the game, it was touchdown or interception. Now he got to the check down, a nice, safe throw and a good one.
Up the middle, here's Taylor. And this won't be enough to pick up the first. A gain of two, third and one.
If they're going to get a first down out of this, they're going to have to earn it, because there's been tough going in the interior there. And here we are on third and one. Be prepared. Brace yourself. There'll be some contact going on.
And he is going to have the Chargers first down, and comfortably so, as he gets five there on third and a yard.
Third and one, who are you going to call? Not the scat back. You go with the big man, hand him the ball, and let him get upfield and pick up a first down.
First and 10, Taylor now. DeMarcus Lawrence in on the tackle.
That felt like a trap, because it looked to me like the opposing front was on that play from the get-go. They had everyone crashing the ball carrier before he even made the line, and they hold him to just a yard.
Second down, another run with Taylor. And some nice running going to get him down close to a first down at the Rams 42. 58 yards rushing for him now in the ball game.
This drive is turning into an extended one, and the guy carrying the ball, he's becoming more like a body blows guy. Every carry is putting some damage on the defense. So after a while, I'm not too sure how many guys are going to want to run up and tackle him.
They'll try and run for the first with Taylor. And past the 35, he'll be dropped a yard or two shy of the 30. A 10-yard pickup, and it's enough for a Charger first down.
We use the word relentless a lot with guys who are aggressive on the field. In this case, it really fits, doesn't it? How about his ability to break tackles and his feet never stop moving?
First down, it's Fields. Oh, the out route, he finds Hardman. He's going to go out of bounds, but he takes this one down just shy of the 20. They get 10 more there, and I believe that'll be enough for another first down. It will. And he's top five in the league in terms of receiving yardage because of plays like that. What have you seen from him on film that you like so much?
Well, I'll strip away everything else and get to what we call the moment of truth. When the ball's arriving and there's a defender there, he just comes down with the ball. He competes and takes it away. Great hands, great ability to finish the catch.
That's good. The completion there for 7 yards, and it'll be second down. Running straight ahead, Taylor. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. So not a lineman, but the tight end instead this time, drawing the holding call.
And more what you're getting with tight ends are guys who are much more receiver than blocker. They may be willing, but that might not be their thing. Oftentimes, they'll be the ones getting the penalties.
Now they face a second and long following the holding penalty. From the gun, it's Taylor. And able to get about 3 as he's taken down right at the 20. In search of 8 yards on third down. They've already converted 2 of these on this drive, 2 for 2. Fields now to throw. He'll check this one down to Taylor. And they're going to get him down well short of the first, as he can only get this to about the 19. They'll get only a yard out of that, and it'll bring up fourth down.
As a defense, you're more balanced when you're in zone coverage because you're able to keep your eyes on the quarterback and see the play develop in front of you. They're able to keep the quick pass in front of them and stop it right at the line of scrimmage.
Fourth down, Fields has to have this one. Flushed out right. And he's brought down. Can't do anything with a football. It's a sack and a turnover on downs. The fourth down play doesn't work for the Chargers. And the Rams are going to take possession of the turnover on downs. They'll try and run some clock with Fournette. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. And when do they start thinking about burning these timeouts? They've got all 3 still defensively.
To me, you have to start right now. Here's the time, and that means you've got to stop them on defense, not give up the yardage, use your timeouts in order to get the ball back and try and score yourself. But now is the time to start using those timeouts.
And keep in mind, it'll also stop the clock at the 2-minute warning. They'll get only 3 there, so it leaves them with a 3rd and 7 ahead.
Oh, it's time to give a little credit there to the defense. They played that very well because it was a drag route, and he ran it a little shallower than normal as he worked straight across the field. He was hoping he'd get lost behind the defensive line, but once he made the catch, nowhere to turn upfield and gain any yardage.
From the shotgun, Zappe buying time to his left. And that nearly the pick that they needed. He couldn't pull it in, though, and it's fourth down.
Sometimes the game is pretty simple. Put a few extra defensive backs on the field, give them nowhere to throw the football, force the incompletion, and get off the field on third down.
Now whistles and a flag down. I think one of the Rams linemen might have moved. Now here's Michael Dixon. And surprisingly, this is the first punt of the game for either team. He was only asked to punt once in the victory last week as he sends this one away. 36 yards on the punt with no return. And it'll be Charger football here as they take over. They've got good starting field position as they come up here first and 10 at the 39-yard line. To throw is Fields. Here's White. They set up the screen. A nice little screen. They get six on first down. Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game.
And a really nice play call there to start the drive, especially if you're a team that has a little bit of a reputation for throwing it downfield. You come out, and you think maybe you can catch them off guard a little bit, and they did. Little screen pass, backdoored them, and that time worked well for a solid gain.
That's going to be caught by Tony, and the tackle going to be made at the 38. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. They run straight ahead here with White. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
I like the call there because that was one to take time off the clock and get them closer to getting out of here with a W. In the mind of the play caller, all you want to hear is tick, tick, tick.
The last run got a couple. Here's second and 8. Now Fields. Completes it to Hardman. And he'll be brought down on the 30-yard line after a gain of 6. Very sharp here to start this drive, 3 for 3.
Yeah, I like the way he's running this 2-minute drill. Very sharp, very precise in throwing the football.
And he's going to get the first down here as he's taken down at the 22. Now the offense going to use the first of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds left to go in the game. To throw, Fields. That's the tight end, Hurst, with it. And he's going to be brought down at about the 16. Second down at 4. Here's Fields. They'll roll him out right. That's complete, right around the 8. And down inside the 10 here before he's out of bounds, right around the 7. It's an 8-yard pickup, and it leads to a first and goal. All eyes on Fields. This one swung out to Montgomery. He takes it across for the touchdown, and they've taken the lead late in the final minute of the fourth.
Wow. Wow.
What an outstanding drive right there to take the lead, and also, Charles, didn't leave their opposition with a whole lot of time on the clock.
Yeah, I like the way that you're viewing this because they did a tremendous job to put themselves in a position to win, but they can't celebrate just yet. They've got to clamp down on any big plays and force them to use up those timeouts without making any headway.
Aku just hit the field goal. Now he kicks off. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. These guys definitely hoping for a better showing than their last appearance. They couldn't really even move the football much beyond the shadows of their own goalposts, Charles. We'll see if they can get a better, more sustained drive going here.
Yeah, and every team that we ever talk to says the exact same thing. When you start a drive from that deep in your own territory, the goal is a minimum of at least 2 first downs, because even if you have to punt then, you change the field position, right? You flip the field a little bit. They didn't get that done. This time they want to string together a nice drive and help themselves out.
Zappy to throw.
And that will be incomplete with a clock showing 18 seconds now to go.
And let's face it, this defense has had its share of struggles all game long, and they know that they can put it all behind them if they defend well here in the two-minute drill. Excellent coverage right there to force the incompletion.
Zappe dancing to his left. He forces one there. It's a potential dagger as it's intercepted. It's Eric Harris who picks it. And the Chargers have just about shown up this football game.
And the tough thing is when he goes back and reviews the film, he'll see that he already escaped the pocket. He could have gotten more himself by using his legs, and that might have been the better choice there instead of challenging the zone. A miscalculation on his part, and he pays for it with the interception.
The Charger drive about to get going. They'll start on the ground here on first down. And good running there as he'll take this all the way up to midfield. And the clock will now stop as a timeout is called with 5 seconds left. And they'll indeed take a knee. Now the Rams will signal for a timeout, their second. And as the two teams talk it over on their respective sidelines, we take a break. And they take a knee. Now the defense will burn their third and final timeout. And as the two teams talk it over on their respective sidelines, we take a break. So first and second down went in the wrong direction. They'll try to do better here on third and 13. Victory formation, time for the Chargers. They take a knee. So this one's over. It's in the win column for the LA Chargers, and they were spurred on by a strong performance in that fourth quarter as they held their opponents off the scoreboard.
Everyone wants to pitch a shutout for the entire game, but when you throw one in the fourth quarter, that tells everyone that you're getting stronger and dominance is starting to take over, right? The way that you close, the way that you finish, that gets preached to you from the time you're playing Little League football all the way up through. And they closed them out with a big-time performance down the stretch.
So, for the Chargers, they continue to show they'll be a tough out in the playoffs as they move to 14-2 on the year. And for Charles Davis and our entire crew here at EA Sports, I'm Brandon Gauden, saying so long, everybody.